Hello students, welcome back to the biology class. So in the last class we did the topic of gene expression and we did slight amount of introduction to the mechanism of regulation of the gene expression. We learned that the master copy is the DNA and the antisense strand or the template strand will be read by the polymerase enzyme from 3' to 5' direction, and this causes the formation of the information copy or the working copy, which is the messenger RNA and which is read from 5' to 3' direction. We learned in the last class that genes are expressed to form proteins, and that means polypeptide expresses the gene by forming structural proteins, enzymes, hormones or antigen. And we understood that whether it is the formation of messenger RNA or the tRNA or the rRNA, because all of them are involved in the process of the gene expression. Because even if any of these RNAs are missing, then the process of gene expression or polypeptide formation would not be possible. We learned the collinearity between DNA, RNA and polypeptide also in the last class, and we learned a very simple logic that one codon of the DNA will code for one codon of the messenger RNA, and that will code for one amino acid, or otherwise we can say three nucleotides of DNA, because three nucleotides will join to form one codon. So three nucleotides of the RNA will code for one amino acid. And then I gave you a simple example, a logical one, that if there are 100 amino acids in a chain, that means there are 300 nucleotides involved, or you can say there are 100 codons involved. Then we did one of the example in the last class, and then we moved on to the regulation of the gene expression. That we learned that some genes are always functional, which are called as the housekeeping gene or the constitutive gene, and some genes will function only when there is requirement of that to do so, and that means they are luxury genes or non-constitutive genes, and then or otherwise also called as regulated genes. And then some genes are found in single copies, some are found in few copies, and some are found in many copies. This is all because the homeostasis could be maintained, or the products required, if the products required are in huge amount and it can be quickly requirement of a huge amount, in that case it is always better for a gene to have many copies. Those genes which continue to function always at a constant type of speed, then there is a single copy, or generally few copies are there for that. We have done these things already before in the topic of types of genes, the last class. Now, we learned in the last class that the four levels of regulations are possible in the case of the eukaryotic machinery, and that is at the transcriptional level, otherwise post-transcriptional processes level, otherwise transport or translation. But when we talk about the prokaryotic machinery, there is only one level of regulation possible, and that is the beginning of the transcription, because we learned in the last class that these things are missing in the case of the prokaryotic system, and these two things are able to be coupled in the case of the prokaryotic system. So the transcription itself has to be stopped if the gene expression has to be regulated. We learned that luxury genes or regulated genes or non-constitutive genes are of two types. Some are inducible and some are repressible. Now, inducible genes are those genes which are always switch on, so which are always switch off, and they will be switched on if there is the presence of a substrate which is called as inducer. So if inducer is present, these genes will become functional. As long as inducer is missing from the picture or the scene, then these genes will not function. Then there are genes which are called as repressible genes, and these genes are always working, and they will switch off if the product accumulates, or you can say accumulation of product will become a repressor for them. So now there are two methods of control over the gene expression. One is negative control and the second is the positive control. Please remember one thing: whether the mechanism come in inducible system or the repressible system, both type of controls will be there. So what is negative control? If a gene, which is called in NCERT as I gene, I does not stand for inducer, I stand for regulatory gene. So the negative control is but when the product of the regulatory gene shuts off the expression, it is called as negative control. And when the product of the regulatory gene activates the gene, then it is called as the positive control. Then we learned that Jacob and Monod in 1961, they performed many experiments on Escherichia coli. It was regarding the metabolism of lactose, and then they observed that there is operon concept, and operon is but we learned in the last class, a system of genetic material which acts as a single regulated unit with one or more structural genes, operator gene, promoter gene, regulator gene, and its functions are under the control of repressor and inducer, or otherwise co-repressor. And we need to understand today's class we'll be understanding that how these things are made available from outside. This concept is very common among prokaryotes. Eukaryotes also have operon, but that is a slightly more complex type of operon, and NCERT has skipped it. But a few lines about the eukaryotic system also I will be discussing with you. So the first operon discovered is the lac operon, which was discovered by Jacob and Monod in 1961. And we learned in the last class that NCERT has mentioned few more operons, so it is always good to go through each line of NCERT. So learn these name also. So operon can be inducible operon, or it can be repressible operon. That means the gene could be always switch off and will function when inducer is there. That is called inducible. Otherwise, the gene would be always working and it will be switched off if there is repressor present there.